Hey guys, long time no see. Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome to my channel. Today, I am making warm, comforting, creamy mushroom soup. I had some mushroom soup while I was away on vacation, and it was only right that I recreated a recipe for my hungries out there. So without further ado, let's get into this video. Okay, so first things first, I'm gonna start off with mushroom medley. I get this from Whole Foods. You can get any type of mushrooms you like. I prefer these little, like, I don't even know the name of them, but they have like a really large cap and then a really skinny body. If you guys know the name of it, type it down below. But those are my favorite mushrooms to use because they release a lot of water and they crisp up beautifully. So we're gonna use those for garnish. So I'm separating all of my mushrooms and I'm gonna start browning these mushrooms with a little bit of butter in a pan and a little bit of salt. If you have white wine, feel free to deglaze the pan with white wine too because it is such a beautiful flavor. Actually, I do think I do that, so I'm getting ahead of myself. So as you can see, I'm just going ahead, sprinkling my mushrooms into the butter, letting it brown with a pinch of salt. And you want these to be like crispy, salty little morsels to kind of like break up the velvety texture of the soup. So that's why I'm browning these mushrooms like this. All right, so now they're nice and brown. You can see that that butter has browned a bit. I'm taking some of my favorite white wine. It is a DOCG, which means the Italian government puts its stamp of approval on it, so it's some good wine. So I'm gonna go ahead and glaze the pot a little bit, get that nice caramelized nutty butter all mixed in with everything, and then I'm gonna remove it. Don't worry about cleaning out your pan. We're gonna use the same old pan. Throw in a tablespoon of butter and some olive oil, about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And we're gonna get started with our onions. I love me some onions and garlic when it comes to a good soup. So I'm melting down my butter. I'm going in with my diced onion. And I'm gonna let that kind of caramelize a little bit and brown before I add my garlic. I have some fresh dill, so I'm gonna go ahead and chop those up as well as my garlic. And then once my onions are nice and brown, I'm gonna go ahead and throw my garlic in whole. I'm doing that because we're gonna blend everything down, okay? We're also gonna go ahead and throw our mushrooms in there. I have like shiitake mushrooms, some portobellos, I have some oyster mushrooms. Use whatever mushrooms you like, but definitely keep, what is it called? Definitely use shiitake mushrooms because they have a really beautiful flavor and it's gonna give your soup a nice depth of taste instead of just plain regular button mushrooms. Do not use button mushrooms, okay? So as you can see, I deglazed my pan with a little bit more white wine. You don't need that much, probably a good 2-3 tablespoons. Now I'm gonna start seasoning up my pot because I would like for my seasonings to kind of get warmed and release fragrances. So I have opened up a little well in my mushroom garlic mixture and I add pepper seeds, Italian seasoning, and some salt and black pepper. Definitely add whatever else you like, but I was good with just that. And then I'm going in with about 1 tablespoon of fresh minced dill. That dill is going to do something special to the dish, so do not skip. If you can't get your hands on fresh dill, dry dill is just as fine. Again, you only need about 1 tablespoon of that. As you can see, I'm just cooking everything down. It has that beautiful color to it, that nice brown color. So I'm going to go in with some chicken bone broth. You don't have to use bone broth. I just prefer that, so that's what I'm going in with. But you can use chicken stock. You can use regular chicken broth. And we're going to use about... Well, for here, I used about 2 cups, and I let it come to a simmer. And as you can see, I'm assembling my blender. I'm using the Vitamix because it's one of the best out there. And now I'm just pouring everything into the blender, all the liquid, all the mushrooms. You want to make sure every single bit and piece of anything is up in that blender because we want to puree it. We want to turn it into a beautiful, smooth consistency. And so you don't need to blend it that long. Just blend it long enough until everything comes together and is one smooth, velvety consistency. Okay, as you can see, that soup is piping hot. All right, so I poured everything back into my soup pot, and I have my fire on low. I'm just allowing it to simmer. I'm gonna go in with a handful of Parmesan cheese. In total, I used about 3/4 of a cup, like a half a cup to 3/4 of a cup of Parmesan cheese. And then, as you can see, it's starting to thicken up. So I'm adding some heavy cream just to add an element of velvetiness. I feel like I said that word velvety a lot during this episode. Oh well, that's what it is. It's smooth. It's sexy. It like velvet. Okay. So I added about a half a cup of heavy cream. If you want to thin out your soup a little bit more, feel free to go in with some more chicken broth. Not heavy cream though, because heavy cream eventually will thicken up as well. So you want to use chicken broth to thin it out. Okay, now I'm going on to garnish. I have a couple of chives that I'm just going to finely slice and dice just for garnish, and then to add a little extra pop of flavor. It has like a nice little oniony burst of flavor, but it's very subtle. It's not too pungent in your face like regular onion, so definitely use chives or green onion if you don't have chives. You can use green onion for sure. And also it gives a little difference in texture, which you'll need. If you're eating a bowl that is full of the same consistency when it comes to soup, you want some things in there to kind of break up the texture of it. So for me, I'm gonna plate up my little bowl of soup. I'm gonna sprinkle some chives on top. And then I'm also gonna add those crunchy bits of mushroom that we cooked earlier. That's gonna add a beautiful diversity of textures while you're eating it. Trust me, don't skip on this. Now for my secret weapon. You ready? Bam. Truffle oil. Yes, a little bit of truffle oil just to finish it on top gives it the perfect umami depth of flavor. Oh my gosh, if you don't have truffle oil, please go get some. It's delicious. And that's it. That is my mushroom soup. I hope you guys like this recipe. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe, and also don't forget about your girl on Instagram. You want to stay connected? Hit me up at The Hungry Jawn on Instagram. All right, talk to you guys later. Bye.